teased that I was going to kind of talk about the good and the bad here with the Cowboys. I thought it was bad that they only ran 52 offensive plays. Because that's what I was, I mean, it bothered me because of the quarterback situation.
You wanted to see more?
I wanted to see more. But I understood, you know, I'm glad that the special teams thing, you know, with what's going on with Turpin, I'm glad that it was shown and how they can have some success doing that. I hated the fact, talking about special teams, I hated the fact that Mike, and people are going to complain at me for saying this, I hated the fact that he went for two. You know, I when on the second touchdown because
they hit Ferguson.
You need to see the kickers.
I wanted to see the kickers.
Right.
That's a 33 yard attempt right there. You know, let me see. And that was the problem with Maher was that they moved on from him because he was missing extra points. So, I mean, go ahead and kick the extra point. You know, go ahead and see. I think
that's a good point.
You know, I understand. Maybe you're in. Bobby had a theory that because Cooper Rush was going to come out of the game.
Mm-hmm.
So why not give him one more throw? And they didn't throw the ball all that much. But I'm like, okay. But you also need to see what your kicking situation is right now.
I'm with you on that. As far as the not more passes, they ran the ball a lot. And I think they're trying to get into the ratio that they want to establish for the regular season.
Oh, but that's the thing about it, though, is really the only starter we think, or maybe I think, that played on the offensive line in that game was the left guard, which was Tyler Smith. Everybody else was a backup guy.
Gosh, the fact that that's even a doubt is making my blood boil.
Well, there's something. Gavin brought up the point.
What the hell are we doing?
Well, Gavin brought up the point about there's somebody in the building that likes Connor McGovern. And I never felt like that, you know, that he was – Joe Philbin didn't initially like Connor McGovern. Didn't. And, you know, and – he really wasn't on board initially. I say initially. I'm not saying maybe it might change now. But he wasn't initially on board with Tyler Smith. We said that on several shows. So it's kind of weird how that whole dynamic is playing out right now. But, those were a couple of things that I noticed. Okay, talking about the guys that, you know, when you start to talk about guys that played well, I thought Matt Farniak played well, the center there. And, again, I'm going to get the All-22, and I'll have an even – clear of you this evening, but I thought that Farniak played well. I talked about Connor McGovern. I thought he played well at right guard. I thought that the inside three actually did a pretty good job of controlling the Chargers inside three, and that's why they were able to kind of have some success running the football. I mean, Farniak, guy plays with some power,
mm-hmm.
and he's athletic enough to second level block as well. So I was pretty pleased by that whole thing. I had no idea. Okay. Did we ever talk about Josiah Bronson at all?
No, dude. No. 94. He was making appearance after appearance for a while, and I'm going, who's 94?
This is one of those strange things where you go, like, you watch guys play, and he's like a second-year guy, and you're like, well, where's he been? And then all of a sudden he shows up in the game, and he's making tackles behind the line of scrimmage. He's throwing blockers aside. He's getting pressure. And I was thinking, well, who the hell is this guy?
Yeah.
So I'm interested to see, is there something I might have missed? That's why I was going to check with you guys, because I know we all had the opportunity to watch practice and we watched, you know, but this was just one of those, did he have just one of those games where all of a sudden it was, you know.
Yeah. It's the first I've noticed him, but he jumped off the screen at me for a while.
It's interesting, and I wonder what that balance is compared to a guy that really didn't flash at all in practice. And maybe he's improved since we've left.
Sure.
Versus a guy that, all right, one game, here he is making some plays for you, and in your evaluation, how much, you know, you put into that versus practice.
Man, I'll tell you, the other guy on the D-line that jumped out to me was old Chauncey Golston, man.
See, that was the next guy I was going to mention right there. And in the Denver game, he played more as a defensive end than he did as a defensive tackle. So I think they're trying to kind of find a spot for him.
Yeah, they started him at tackle in this one and then moved him to end.
That's the flexibility he brings. They had him put the weight on so that he could play a little bit of that three technique, but imagine him as a guy setting the edge on rundowns.
Yeah, see, that's when you watched him play at Iowa. He was the guy that was more like what you get with Tank Lawrence. Run at you, hard to get to the outside, plays off blocks, plays with power. That's right. Why I thought he was an ideal backup left end.
He's a fascinating one to watch. I don't think he's in any danger of not making the team.
Gosh, no.
But I did want to ask, because he's not a guy that I thought stood out at all at camp.
Yeah.
Didn't do anything last week. But he did have a decent game against the Chargers. But that's really the first time this entire offseason that I thought, okay, there's Chauncey Golston. Otherwise, I thought it's been a pretty meh offseason for him.
Is it too late for Tristan Hill?
No. No, he's coming.
Tristan Hill's should make your team over Carlos Watkins. That's why I texted you and we talked a little bit yesterday, yeah. Brian, about, all right, what could you get for a Tristan Hill? Because right now, you need a swing tackle. I'm not buying into Josh Ball. I'm getting sick of people trying to act like, okay, so he's gone from god-awful to like, okay, he was bad. So we're seeing like a little bit of improvement, but he's still not good at all. It's not enough for me.
Yeah.
If you had to play a game and Josh Ball starting for you, you're in a load of trouble.
We thought
this dude can't play.
Did we think the same thing about Steele?
No. Steele at least showed you a little bit more upside than Josh Ball. I mean, in passing downs, Josh Ball's gotten a lot better in run blocking.
Sure.
But in passing downs, that dude is getting his ass beat just about every single time.
I think the thing with Tristan Hill, I don't know if it's too late for him. I mean, I wonder if Bobby and I were talking about this. The same thing happened with Taco. You know, that third year, Taco all of a sudden was like, he had a really good preseason and then they just moved on from him.
Yeah, and they traded him to Miami.
Yeah, I wonder if Tristan Hill's in that same boat where you see in the flashes.
But I think it's a lot better than Taco. Like Taco's production was he was up against a tight end that never came out of his stance. Or, you know, for whatever reason, someone missed the assignment. With Tristan Hill, like, his biggest concerns were his body and his motor. And I wouldn't have bet on him remedying both of those, but he did, Brian.
Yeah.
You know, this is a really active guy. And I know he lacks all the traits to be a prototypical guy. But he's effort and he's got power. His legs are huge.
Yeah.
And he's a different bodied guy, but I think he's going to be effective, and it surprised me.
Yeah, to me, you know, the Denver game, he was real close to getting a sack that ended up being a touchdown pass. This time around, he was able to make something happen there in the pocket.
He's going.
Yeah.
Yeah. I you know, sometimes you have this big challenge and the coaches are like, he'll never make it because of that. And that makes that player obsessed with proving people wrong. And now he's actually working the hardest amongst the defensive linemen. It's like the ball is snapped and he's going crazy to prove everybody wrong. That's what I see in Tristan Hill. And I think a tremendous amount of credit goes to him for saving a career.
I mean, if you want to trade him, fine, but that's not a guy that you just cut and just let a second round pick walk out the door like that.
How about Israel Mukwamu?
I was ready. I thought Bell had taken his job. Izzy, with his versatility now to play corner and safety, and how well apparently he's played since we left Oxnard, and then he showed it in the game, he's made the team.
Yeah, I think that when you start to talk about the numbers now, 6-4, 5-5, when the safety's in the corners, you know, there's people I'm talking to that they're talking about not giving up on Joseph.
At this point, I'd give up on Nation Wright before I give up on Kelvin Joseph.
It's funny how Wright has looked worse than he was great in practice, and he's looked bad in these games.
Right,
which I think has been a problem. And one final thing, real quick, before I get out of here, we talked about Jake Ferguson already, the tight ends. How about the running back thing, real quick, with Malik Davis? Which way are you going on that? There's no way in heck they can keep four running backs.
That's a shame. So I like both those guys.
I know. But I
think Dowdle or Davis.
I like Davis a little more.
Yeah,
right now. I think so too. I think I'm leaning towards Davis.
Hasn't Rico been hurt? Better. Rico keeps getting hurt.
Well, the Rico thing about it is, man, I mean, he's super tough. The thing with Davis, though, that was they had a vision for the player and what he can do.
Yeah.
And I think he's living up to their vision. I think it's going to be real hard for them to put him on the street.